Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Neve and I have not posted a YouTube video in about 400 days, but instead of focusing on that fun fact, we're gonna focus on what I'm about to show you, which is my annual Lush Christmas sale haul. Yay! So let's do that. Alrighty, I have six things I'm gonna be showing. Excuse me, I have five things I'm gonna be showing. And yeah, let's get started. So the first thing I picked up in the sale was this. This is the Snow Fairy Naked Solid Body Conditioner. You use that the same way basically you would soap or the Naked Shower Gels, which they discontinued. Why? You just take it in the shower, you rub it on your wet body, it melts to body temperature, and then use it as you would any body product. The Snow Fairy scent I find in soap form and this kind of form is not super strong, so it's actually quite pleasant, but the full-on like Snow Fairy shower gel I'm not a big fan of. I think it's a bit too sweet. The full price of this is 12 euros, so obviously 50% off. I got it for 6. I have used it and I find it lathers quite easily, because I did get one of those before and I found you had to like scrub and then only a tiny bit of product came off. So yes, Snow Fairy Naked Body Conditioner. I would repurchase this. Next up, I have two different soaps. These were about full price, $6.50, so they were going on sale for $3.25, which obviously you can buy a bar of soap for pretty cheap nowadays, but I go to the Lush haul because I'm like, let's treat myself. The end. That is why I go. So first up, we have this, which is the Polar Bear soap. This just, it looks so cute. To me, it actually looks more like a koala bear than a polar bear, but hey ho. Oh, smells so good. Apparently this is in the classic Lush Snow Cake scent, which Snow Cake, I'm not familiar with her work. I've never heard of her. It's classified as a, what's that thing called? Frangipan? Marzipan? Marzipan fragrance. And to me, this is quite a subtle, it reminds me of like a baby product. It's giving me oat, almond, baby product vibes. And I did try this, it's quite like a milky soap and it's a very pleasant scent, quite subtle I would say, but it does linger a little bit and it feels very nice and moisturizing. And just look how cute. Next product slash soap that I have is this one. This is the Baked Alaska soap. Oh my god, it says Lush. I didn't even notice that. Cute. It's your classic soap, so it's not like milky or anything like that. Is that how people describe soaps? I think so. No, it's not creamy. Better word. Reminds me of the Shooting Star soap, which I'm pretty sure they don't still make. They describe it as producing bright, refreshing citrus suds. It's made with lemon and grapefruit and the base is rapeseed and coconut oil. Delicious. Buy that soap. If anything, buy that soap if you like citrus. Now, the last two things that I purchased, I will admit, were kind of me being like, it's on sale, so I should buy it, but I do not need it. And they were two of the Lush lip scrubs. I actually already have, I think, two of these that are very full. So this was definitely me just being like, I want it. Which, you know, treat yourself. I guess that's okay. The first one is Golden Pineapple and the other one is the Galaxy Lip Scrub. Were these Christmas scents? I think so. Were they just made before a certain date? I don't know. Basically, the Golden Pineapple says buff and polish with golden castor sugar, pineapple powder, and a touch of warming ginger. Which in my opinion, if you blindfolded me or just didn't tell me and asked me to smell this, to me it gives like caramelized banana vibes. Actually, I guess it kind of does smell like pineapple. I feel like my first scent I'm getting caramel, banana, and then in the back I smell a bit of pineapple, but very subtle. Maybe it's the ginger just overpowering. These lip scrubs I use every so often. Obviously I scrub my lips and then basically just lick all the sugar off my lips because they taste delicious. The Galaxy one is Blue Raspberry Sugar Exfoliant will leave your lips feeling out of this world. If I had to choose just one of these, I think I would go Golden Pineapple because I quite like the scent. The Galaxy one definitely gives me American Candy Blue Raspberry vibes, or it also reminds me of the slushy, the blue slushy, and it is literally just electric blue. Golden Pineapple full price was $7.95. They charged me $3.97. However, Galaxy, which I don't think I realized when I was buying, full price is 9 euro, so it was 4.50. I don't know why there's such a price difference. I also saw a sign saying lip scrubs 10 euro. So they just all seem totally randomly priced. So those five products are everything that I picked up in this year's sale for 2021. And I do have some things from years past that I'm gonna talk about now and compare, contrast, review. Okay, so in the last Lush sale haul video that I made, which is 2019, I showed these toothy tabs. These are the dirty ones And in that video, obviously I hadn't tried them yet, but since then I have tried them, and I have to say, out of all the toothy tabs I've tried, which are the Boom, Limelight, and Dirty, Dirty is the least offensive flavor. Cooling Spearmint and Feel Good Neroli Oil. I'm happy to continue using these. Glad I got those. The other two flavors, no sir. And then this product, super cute, is from my first Lush haul video. And I think it's the Ro Argan Naked Body Conditioner, which I just want to compare to the Snow Fairy one for a second. Here's the like full size you get, and this is what I have left. When I bought this, I was quite disappointed. I was looking for naked products because I quite like them. However, this one I said felt quite abrasive, and you really need to scrub, scrub, scrub to get a tiny bit of product, which I stand by that. Though I did use it recently and it seemed to give me product a bit easier. Maybe I was using it wrong. Oops. However, this one feels way more kind of creamy, waxy. Just feels like it works a lot quicker. However, this one had glitter in it, which I think was a really nice touch because it would stay on your skin and looked really pretty. While the Snow Fairy one works better, I do wish it had a bit of this glitter. And the last thing I want to mention in this video is, in my last sale video, I showed two of the seasonal naked shower gels, which, as I said earlier, Lush have unfortunately discontinued. I don't know why. People were saying they were just glorified bars of soap, which was kind of true, but I did like them as, you know, a fun treat yourself shower product. But I heard reports that they were changing the formula, but that was like 2 years ago and they're still not back, so I don't think they're ever coming back. So this bit of information is kind of pointless, but since I like to ramble, we're gonna go through it anyways. In my last video, I showed, I think it was the Cinders and Snow Fairy, no, Cinders. Maybe Cinders, I don't remember. It was a gold naked shower gel, and I carefully documented in the beginning of 2020 when I was using it and how long it lasted. And I'm gonna put on screen, I have 6 photos that I took between the 5th of February and the 1st of July. So the first photo I took was after a month, well, like a bit over a month of using it. And then the last photo I took, it's a small little stump, and I have no further photos than that. And I think I remember it broke into 2 pieces and I just finished it. So that naked shower gel thing lasted me like 7 months, which is pretty good. I'm pretty sure it was about 7 something euro, so like 1 euro a month. And yeah, that's a little update I wanted to give on that. In case you were thinking, oh, I'm gonna buy one of those discontinued Lush naked shower gels, I know it will last me about 7 months. And the other thing I had in my last video was the Jersey Bounce tub of shampoo, which, because it was like 2 years ago at this point, I don't remember. I'm pretty sure I used it at least 20 times. I can't fully remember though, but I did quite like that shampoo. However, 10 euro for that amount, I don't think, and that's only half price, I wouldn't repurchase it, but it was nice while it lasted. But again, irrelevant, because I don't even know if they make that shampoo anymore. Let me have a look.
Lush Jersey Bounce.
Okay, I don't even think they sell that shampoo anymore, so another totally irrelevant piece of information. You are welcome. So yes, those are all the products and information I have to share for my Lush Christmas Sale Haul 2021. I don't know why every time I say that I have to like think each word separately in my head, but I do. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you live near a Lush store, I'd recommend going in, checking it out. I don't know how much luck you would have, as people were going a bit crazy now, grabbing stuff, hoarding stuff, 2 of everything in a big fat basket. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you had a nice Christmas / festive period with whoever you celebrated with. And here is to 2022 being a good year, and hopefully me making more than 1 YouTube video in the entire 12-month calendar year. Goodbye.